Hey, I'm Zane. I'm 30 and I'm from the great state of Indiana. And as a Hoosier, I have voted in every general and primary election that I've been able to since I turned 18 and proudly voted for John McCain for President of the United States. I've never envisioned an election where I would not feel compelled to vote for the Republican nominee because I'm pro-life, I'm conservative, I'm all for balanced budgets, I'm for national security, defending our military, and having law and order. But sadly, since I voted for number 45 in 2016, all of those promises, all the things that he guaranteed would happen in his term, haven't happened. I have never felt less safe in the United States than I do right now with him in charge. He continues to pick fights with members of the media, and as a 30-year-old who works as a sports editor for a weekly newspaper, what fight are you trying to pick against me? I'm making $25,000 a year to continue to put out a publication for my community to stay informed and involved. Yet there you are, tweeting away baseless facts and claims, attacking all the hardworking journalists, those on the front lines, and that political divisiveness, just right there alone. You don't even have to look at all the other things that you've lied and spread and tweeted. That attitude towards journalists is a reason why in the last couple of weeks we've seen so many hardworking men and women in front of the camera, behind the camera, writing, chronicling all of these historic events to be attacked by police, to be attacked by others. You have created that negative dialogue. The freedom of the press is one of the greatest American liberties that we have, and it's something that I went to college for, graduated, and I'm proud to be in the profession. You, sir, are a disgrace to that office because any president, Democrat, Republican, Federalist, Whig, whoever, knows the importance of a free and independent press. You, sir, are caught up in your own egotistical dream or nightmare that you're desperately trying to find the quick way out. And let me tell you, sir, the quickest way out is you losing in November 2020. Good riddance.